Today we are back at Little Customs, and today I'll be bluffing. Make GTI. Make GTI. Today I'll be installing a subwoofer once again, because many of you guys have asked me like multiple times how to connect up a DVC subwoofer. So today I'll be showing you guys how to connect up a DVC subwoofer, and I'll be showing you guys how to seal up your subwoofer box properly, because sometimes there are a few rattles in your subwoofer box and you think the subwoofer is faulty or something is not wrong or something's rattling inside of the car, but it's actually just your subwoofer not being sealed up properly. So today I'll be using some normal, like, it's like normal cheap sealing. I'll be just sealing up the subwoofer box inside, and after that I'll be connecting up the subwoofer, like connecting it up like a DVC subwoofer. I'll be showing you guys how to connect up that subwoofer. I'll be putting it inside the box, I'll be laying out the wiring, and I'll be putting it inside the car, and I'll give you guys a demo on actually how it plays. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Today we're just chilling inside the house, we're very very bored, and there's not actually much to do to the cars. It's just I'm waiting on parts, and the weather isn't nice because I was supposed to install the master and slave cylinder in the Honda, but because the weather is so crap and it's very cold, we don't want to be tampering with any water and shit like that. We're waiting for nice clear weather, and we would like to clean the engine bay and clean the entire car, and I'm just gonna park the car once again. Another update for you guys on the GTI might just arrive this week. So they are busy with the turbo at the moment, and I'm really hoping that the car actually arrives this week. So that's another update on that, but let's get back to today's content. And I'll be starting off by just showing you guys how to seal up a subwoofer or subwoofer box. Yeah. For today's video, we will be needing all of this laying in front of us. So we have the subwoofer, we have the screws, the nails, and whatsoever. We have the sealant, and then I don't know this gadget, what this gadget is called, but you can just, yeah, you can just buy the gadget at Midas or any spare shop or hardware shop. It's fairly cheap as well. And obviously, you'll be needing a screwdriver, and I have all my wires in there how to connect up the subwoofer. I'll be showing you guys that in a while. Then we have the subbox. So the subbox isn't sealed properly inside, and what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna be sealing it in each corner. So all the corners inside I'm gonna try to seal up like properly, and I want it to be set properly before I actually put it in the subwoofer. So just note, whenever you seal up the inside of the subwoofer box, just note it will have to be completely dry. And sometimes it's always nice to actually, like, whenever you assemble the subwoofer box, to actually use some nice wood glue, wooden glue or wood glue, and you can actually just like use some nice screws or nuts or fuck, whatever you want to use to actually assemble the subwoofer box. But for me, I just use normal nails, and it was already like, what you call it, covered with material, and it was already put together. So what I'm just gonna do, I'm just gonna try to make the subwoofer box play a little bit better by sealing it up on the inside, placing the subwoofer on the inside, connecting it up, and connecting it up to my 2-channel amplifier, which is in the yellow thing. So let's get straight into this video. Connecting up a DVC subwoofer, it will usually have like four of these terminals, or usually will have just like two negatives, two positives. So one of these, this one is the positive, this one's the negative, this one is the negative, this one is the positive. So what we're gonna do is that to connect it up to 4 ohm, we're gonna connect one positive to one negative, and then the other positive will be going out and the other negative will be going out, if it makes sense like that. If you wanted to connect your subwoofer, which you have to double check if your subwoofer is compatible for 2 ohm or mono is running 1 ohm to the amplifier, you have to connect up negative to negative, positive to positive, and run the negative out and the positive out. Then you'll be running like 2 ohm or 1 ohm. I'm 100% not sure, I could be wrong as well, but I'll put the diagram on the screen right now so you guys can just double check if I'm correct or not. And if my method of explaining wasn't valid enough, I hope the picture will actually justify what I actually meant when I was explaining this right here. But I'm gonna start connecting up the wiring and hopefully it will make a little bit more sense when I connect up the subwoofer. So first of all, what I'm gonna do right now is that I'm gonna connect up this one terminal. Fortunately, I didn't have another terminal, so I'll be just connecting up just like this. Just note you will have to have a nice wire. You don't want any, you don't necessarily want to use speaker, like normal speaker wire on this. It's always nice to use like a 4 gauge or 8 gauge on the subwoofers because it's nice to carry out the power from the amplifier to this subwoofer right here. But I'm just going to be using this wire right here and this one will be completely fine. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to connect up one negative, which is the one right here. And then I'll be putting this side on the positive, which is this one right there. For this example right here, I'll be using the black one for the negative. And I'll be using the red one, which is right here, for the positive. So very, very easy. You only have one negative and one positive left, so you'll be connecting up the red wire. It doesn't need to be red, but you just connect up this wire to the... This one here is positive, so this wire will be running to the amplifier. And then we have the black one right here, which is the negative. And this one will be running to the amplifier as well. So that's a very, very easy way to connect up 4 ohm. The other method I was explaining to you guys is when you're running this positive to that positive and running it from there, you're running it out. And then this negative you're running to that negative and from there you're running it out to the amplifier. And that you will be connecting up 2 ohm. We'll be putting it in now. So what I meant by let it laying on his face, actually the other way around, Jody. You must face that. Yeah, I must face it the other way around. So what I meant is that the slant, if you check it from this side, the slant will be laying like this. So you guys will see in a moment. I'm just keeping the wires like that. So it will be laying like that inside of the car. And hopefully it will play a little bit better, because if it plays to the boot, the number plate vibrates too much and like leaks come inside the car and stuff like that. So it's better for you to actually play inside of the cabin of the car. And it's a very easy way, because you guys can see right there how to connect it up. Let me focus. Doesn't want to focus, but it can barely see. You guys can see it says bridge from that one to that one. So we'll be using that too. That one is the positive and that one is the negative. So we'll be using that too right there to bridge this subwoofer on this small amplifier. Great, so we got the wires connected to the amplifier. I know the amplifier goes on, everything is connected. So we're just about to test out how this amplifier actually plays and how the subwoofer plays with the box actually being sealed. It's not fully dry yet though, but hopefully it will play a little bit better. We're just gonna put the 6.9s back in the car and then we will be tuning. We're gonna tune this car, Biki. This car needs tune. Biki tuner. Tune ya on the side. Look. Well, the subwoofer actually plays really, really crap in the car, but what I actually managed to do is that... Hello, Trixie! I actually managed to get like a... Trixie! I don't know if you can see, there's like a lappy in that port right there. So I actually just managed to like put like a piece of cloth there in, just to like keep it to block the wind. So meaning it's like a sealed box right now. And it plays way better, to be honest. I'm gonna get the port off real quick and I'm gonna show you guys what it actually looks like. There you guys can actually see what I actually meant. So I just pressed a piece of lap in there and it plays way better. I'm talking about I can at least drive with it daily, so I'm at least satisfied for now. A little bit of bass. But we got another trippy adventure today, is that we're gonna test fit my rim on Jason's car, and if he's satisfied with the fitment, then we might do a swap. Then we might do a swap. So yeah, let's see how it goes. And hopefully I'll be having my six. Yeah, that will be my six set. Six. How do you call it? Six.
Set, yeah.
Sack set. Will be my sack set. on the car. So we were checking it out. Yeah. But I think this wheel will actually be looking better on his car, and that wheel will actually be looking better on my car. And if he likes the wheel, then I'll just do the swap. I just know one of his lips is like completely messed up. Then I'll just do that over, and I'll spray the wheel over eventually, because that wheel looks a very crap color. And yeah. Yeah, let's see how it actually looks on the car. Maybe I might just get a buy for that wheel, then I can actually just sell it. Just another short video for you guys. Just you guys, to play you guys a nice song. And let's check out the gauges. Damn, it looks dope though. There we go, light is on. Lights are off. So, guys, check out Kei Customs. They did an amazing job on my gauges, and I'll definitely recommend them. Just gonna play you guys a non-copyright song real quick. I don't know how's the speaker quality, but yeah, let's check it out. Jason?
Oh yeah, bro.
Like the bass though. Oh yeah. Like why not? Bruh, make use of Kei Customs, they're amazing, bro. You see ya. Look at the strokes, bruh.
Wow.
Look at the strokes, bruh. Just gonna show you guys.
Ah.
Oh yeah. Disco. Look at disco over now. Disco, disco.
Clash, nice.
With an amp in the background. So guys, like I said, please go check out Kei Customs. Their number and their Facebook page is in the description below. If you guys would like to check them out, amazing job. And they're amazing guys. They, I mean, like, I'm sure after the interaction with them, after you buying some fresh gauges and doing them over, you guys will definitely do some future work together as well. So go check out Kei Customs. But for now, this video turned out completely crazy, no lies, because now I'll be T-splitting Jason's trim on my car, and hopefully the wheel will be looking alright on the car. Then I can actually go a little bit lower on the car, because at the moment the car is freak high. And a set of street tires wouldn't look bad on that this wheel as well. These dogs, they just like German too much though. Hello, meet with German winkies. Nah, they love the golf, man. They like the golf. But let me show you guys this wheel right here. You remember, why is the water down here?
And
yo, look here, bro. Jason, what the fuck, bro? Anyways, these are the wheels, and the wheels actually looks good. These are the previous wheels that were on the Civic previously. Well, the wind is effing up everything right now, and the mic is actually inside. But yeah, I'm just gonna show you guys the wheels. So it's really good wheels. It's just the tires have been shaved right there, but that's not a problem, because I'm gonna replace the tires. But very nice wheel though. And hopefully I'll be able to go a little bit lower with these wheels on my car. Yeah, Jason?
Yes.
Oh, Jason, what the god is that even here, hoor? Your poepel.
The fat ass.
The poepel.
Many, many minutes later. You said it would be alright. I tried to stop you asking why. You started out to face it. My heart went off like crazy. You placed your arms on my head. We fell into my small. You started out to face it. My heart went off like crazy.
I would say today was a very successful day. I was just planning on showing you guys how I fit the subwoofer in the car, and now the subwoofer plays better than ever before, just because I blocked it out. I removed the slot, kinda, and then I got these sick wheels on my car. And then Jason's car is looking good. My car is lower. I adjusted the coilovers a little bit lower, and it's still looking good as well. It's just very dirty. But in the future, I will repair that rim, that one rim that Jason actually curb rashed. And eventually, I'll just sell the wheel and buy the wheel I actually want to buy. But for now, I'm grateful for you guys watching my videos. Guys, please like my video and please subscribe to my channel. Please click the notification bell to get notified whenever I'm uploading new content. Grateful for the support. I couldn't do this without you guys. And remember, stop racing and go stunts.